Don't go and run with many things, many activities, many issues, many things, unsolved things that will eat you up. Maybe certain habits which you want to come out, but you do not know what to do. You are running, running, running. The Bible says, stop for a while. Look into yourself. Check your life. And then proceed in life. Get back to ourselves. We'll get back to our root. As we read in the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 18 says, it is the root that sustains the tree. It is the root that feeds the tree, protects the tree. You and I have the root, the Lord our God. So it's an opportunity for us to get back to our God, to get back to our root, to get back where God has placed us. And then re-strengthen ourselves, we move ahead in life. Being aware of a great moment to which God is calling us to come. He told the disciples, come, take time off and be with me. Yes, let's be with him. He's calling us that we may know ourselves. May his light shine upon us that we may begin to know and we begin to guide ourselves. Every day in the cool evening hour, the God Almighty used to come down. And his children, Adam and Eve, like the children who run to see their parents, they used to run. Who is first, me or you? And for him, they are his children. He loved them. He created them in his image and goodness. And that day, he came down looking for them, but they are not there. He was upset. He was worried what happened to them. He began to cry, Adam, where are you? Eve, where are you? They began to say that we are hiding ourselves. In life, you will have many trials and tribulations. I am your God where you can hide yourself. I am your hiding place. But now, instead of hiding in the Lord, being protected in the Lord, they are hiding from the Lord. That's what sin does to man. If the sin takes man away from God and hits man from God. Yes. God began to cry, where are you? Where are you? I have created you to stay in a particular place, but where have you landed up your life to? Where are you supposed to be and where are you staying now? Why this situation? They were saying, we are feeling ashamed. Ashamed? You are not created for shame. Yes. Even today, God continues to ask upon his children, my children, where are you? Where are you supposed to be? And where are you staying now? Where are you landed up? God asks us to go back to our lives, to check our lives. We read in the book of Jude, chapter 1, verse 5 onwards. Those of the Bible, kindly read. Jude, chapter 1, verse 5 and 6. Although you may be aware of it, I wish to remind you that the Lord saved his people from the land of Egypt, but later delivered to death those who did not believe. The God Almighty the God merciful, the God compassionate, came and chose his servant Moses and delivered the people from Egypt. But they went back to slavery. They went back to drink alcohol. They went back to the life of prostitution. They exchanged their wives. They went to the Canaanites day and night. And the God who warned them, they did not listen to. And then God allowed the serpents to bit them. And in a day, 23,000 people were bitten by the snake, and their bodies were thrown out. God, in his mercy, he establishes each one of us in a particular place with a particular mission. If you are in a particular place, you are a father, you are a mother, you are a son, you are a daughter, you are a teacher, you are an engineer. You have got a mission. Through you, God is the source of life, God is the savior, and the same work of giving life, giving saving, is continued in the world, and God chose you and me. God has a purpose. God has a mission. We are not created by ourselves. We are created by God and for God. That's what we read in Colossians 1:16. God is at work in us that his purpose will be fulfilled in our lives. That's what he says in the book of Philippians 2:13. So God is at work in us that his purpose may be fulfilled in our lives. Yes. We read the Holy Bible. God led the people of Israel and kept them. Through them, he wanted to achieve greater heights. When they moved away, from place where God has kept them, they entered into dangerous zone, and they destroyed what God has kept for them, what God has given to them. Where you are, God has placed you, and if you move away from the mission he has given to you, when you move away from the work what has God has given to you, you are going to land up in danger. God said to the angels, you are supposed to be continue to praise and thank God, glorify God. God has given them a mission. God has given them the glory. God has given them the power. But they abandoned their dwelling place. They said, we will raise us up. We will move away from the place where God has given to us. Why we should worship God? Let me become a God. Then God threw them into the world and the hellfire. God has placed each one of us with a standard. Don't throw away your standard for anything. Don't throw away your life for anything. If you lose your standard, you will be lost.